in media for about 20 years now. I started off at SABC, South African Broadcaster, in finance. I'm finance trained, chartered accountant. And I started. We started off starting a new news division at SABC quite a few years ago. And then I moved into television as a GM finance for television and television division at the SABC. I spent about 2-3 years there, and then I moved to SuperSport. I was a CFO at SuperSport for about a year and a half, and I was a CFO at Mnet for about a year and a half. Two separate companies. A lot of people don't know that. And then I moved to Nigeria to start off Mnet Africa. So I set up offices in Kenya, in South Africa, and in Nigeria. And we started off creating reality shows for Africa. So we did Big Brother Africa, Big Brother Nigeria, Idols East Africa, Idols West Africa, created a couple of dramas. You know, Tinsel, one of them is still running up until today in Nigeria. Then after that, after about 2 years of doing that, setting up Mnet Africa, I ran MultiChoice, the pay TV site, selling decoders and managing subscribers for about 3 years as the managing director for MultiChoice in Nigeria. And I spent about 10 years in the group, in the NASPERS MultiChoice group, per se. And then after 10 years, I felt like I needed something different. I thought I was still pretty young, and I wanted to try something a bit different. So I joined a company called Modern Times Group, a Swedish business, based out of Stockholm. And I was in charge of setting up a new division there, creating a media business for them in Africa. So my job really was to go around interacting with various governments and regulators, looking for licenses and trying to buy currently existing free-to-air TV stations and radio stations. After about 2 years, they said they wanted to sell the business. So I thought I would sell the business. I mean, I thought I would buy the business from MTG. And I started looking for money. Started to raise money to buy this business. It was still quite small then. They had a small little pay TV channels business, and then their TV station in Ghana, a TV station in Kenya. I mean, sorry, in Tanzania. And while I was raising money, I met Strive Masiwa, and spoke to him about, you know, investing in my business, and he felt it was too small an investment for him. He told me, look, I'm starting a media company, and why don't you come and run that? You know, and we'll roll up. Whatever you want to do, we'll roll up the business, we'll go and buy the business from MTG, and then we can roll it up into a bigger play. And I said, okay, what do you want to do? So I want to set up a pay TV business to compete with MultiChoice. I said, okay, that sounds interesting. What's your model? And he took me through his model, and I said, okay, I like that model. I think it would work. So I joined Econet Media, and we started off with Econet Media. We've now bought the MTG assets. We've launched, we've expanded that business from those two channels to 11 countries now. So we have 11 TV channels within the space of a year. You know, our vision really is to create the biggest media company in sub-Saharan Africa, outside of South Africa, because we have some intent to go into South Africa, but it's quite limited at this stage. And we want to do this in various ways. One, we want to go into traditional media, which is just your free-to-air stations that I've spoken about, plus pay TV, create a pay TV business. But we also are investing quite heavily in new platforms, which is mobile and broadband. Is how do we tap into the growing broadband market in Africa? But how do we also tap into the growth of smartphones on the continent? And what kind of content and package can we put together that appeals to people who want to consume content over the mobile phones, which is largely millennials? So, you know, so we believe that by harnessing these four businesses together, pay TV, free TV, mobile, broadband, we will easily create the biggest media business in Africa. At the moment, we have our free-to-air station, and it's a sports station. It's called Kwese Free Sport. We've launched in most English-speaking countries in Africa, and we continue to expand. By the end of this year, we will be in all English-speaking countries, in one way or another. So we have our own channel, but we also sell some of our content to affiliates who take a block of our content, a branded block of content, 2-3 hours, depending. So that's one part of our business. The other part is we've now established our pay TV business. So we've launched in Ghana, Zambia, Rwanda, and Lesotho. And we have, and there we're selling set-top boxes, and we've got a bouquet of channels, numbering over 60 now. Our intent is to get about 75 channels, and the most important thing for us is to have premium content. So we want to have at least 40% of our channels being exclusive to Kwese. So we intend to roll out our pay TV business to all the English-speaking countries by the end of the year as well. So we're doing it on a staggered approach. We don't want to, you know, launch in all the countries at one time. We're also in the throes of developing an app, a Kwese app, which serves two purposes. We have a separate app that serves as a TV Everywhere app. That means if you want to consume, if you're a satellite subscriber, you can access our content on your mobile phone or your tablet. Right, through the Kwese, we're putting with TV Everywhere app. But we're also creating a separate app, which is we're trying to figure out what the content offering on that app is going to be. But most certainly it'll have some linear channels, it'll have some free content, it'll have some video on demand content. What I'm trying to figure out now is how do we frame all of that into one seamless product for our consumers. And then of course we're creating our broadband product, as I explained earlier on. It's a product called Kwese Play. And Kwese Play essentially is for homes that have unlimited broadband, right? So it's for a little slightly more affluent customer. And also it also helps us with the fact that some people might never want to switch from multi-choice, but they can take our set-top box and consume content over broadband and be able to still enjoy content from diverse offerings. So we have those four products, but we are also working quite heavily on digital strategy that involves fantasy games, it involves e-gaming. Is what do we do with e-gaming in Africa? We think see some potential there. You know, and we're investing from that point of view, we're investing across the spectrum, across the whole value chain. You know, the actual games themselves, tournaments, hosting of tournaments, setting up channels to showcase people playing the games, etc., etc. So we're really trying to be as diverse as possible. Well, I mean, look. I mean, we are our business. First of all, is Pan-African, so it's across all southern, east, west. But we really believe that by creating products specific for mobile, for example, when I think digital, I think mobile in Africa. And you know, by making sure that we play in that space, we're kind of in a way ensuring that we're able to deliver, expediting the delivery of content over digital platforms. It is a very tricky space. I don't think anybody has figured it out yet, and we're hoping that we will figure it out. But you know, we're not scared of making mistakes. What is important is to realize you made a mistake and to quickly change or change tactics or strategy. So you know, we're taking a strong bet on mobile. If we instead of taking the traditional content delivery mechanisms, which is satellite, really, you know, one thing that incumbents have not done is to try and aggressively attack this mobile and broadband space. And for us, we want to move away from being a platform-specific product. We want to be completely platform-agnostic. So at some point, we want to be able to be so versatile that if, say, some new technology comes up tomorrow that, you know, quickly proliferates, we can be there within 6 months. And our content must be as seamless as possible. And whatever that technology is, because we never know, we can always tell the future, we must be there. Because at the end of the day, we're all about delivering content. We're not about whether it's on a tablet, phone, which phone, or it's on broadband, or it doesn't really matter. The issue is we must be able to deliver content to consumers in a way that is convenient for them. You know, I mean, look, you know, most people have not really geared their content. For example, I mean, for us, a specific aspect of our ecosystem is the car producers, right? We rely heavily on local content. We will rely heavily on local content, and we rely heavily on people creating content at a local level. And what we're seeing is that if we're going to attack mobile, we need to now find different ways of producing content in much smaller portions. time portion. So whether it's 30 seconds, a minute, 1 minute, 1.5 minutes, 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 5 minutes. We need producers to start creating content that is geared for mobile. But you know, they will only do that if they can find a commercial model that works for them. But what's important first is for them to realize that there is this delivery platform that's available to them. And from that, hopefully we'll be able to start moving our ecosystem more towards the digital age. So besides the content producers, who we think have got to be innovative, and we're driving that innovation by creating shorter format content made for mobile, we also are looking at how do we develop small, medium enterprises across Africa. And we're doing this in various ways. We're setting up dealers. We've got a dealer portal. On Questa.com, you'll find a place where you can register as a dealer. We are we're sending set-top boxes online. We are signing up tech knights who are technicians who come and do the installations of your set-top boxes in home. We've got thousands of them across Africa. So we're creating jobs at that granular level, at that micro level, sorry. So for us, you know, we're really, and then hopefully that'll just, having such a large distribution platform around all these dealers, tech knights, etc., we really hope that we can drive growth in economies, and basically by helping fund and assist all these young unemployed people that are looking for an opportunity to get employed in doing something that they love. So we're hoping that we're making a positive contribution towards most economies in which we launch our business. I think, you know, content is king. You know, everybody will always need content. It drives the media landscape completely. If anybody wants to get involved in media, I would start right there. You know, how do I create content that is relevant for my audiences in wherever I am? And then find a platform for that content. So I think, you know, young people have got a big role to play in how we change the African narrative. Because without that narrative, we have no businesses. And I think that millennials have a fantastic opportunity in delivering African stories via multiple means, especially via mobile.